Hey everyone, this is Diana from Artemis in Love, and today I'm going to show you how to make a beautiful fabric satin chiffon. Basically, it's going to be on a hair clip, or you could make it into a brooch, or you could make it into a complete headband. So I'm going to make a headband. So this is just going to be the first step. And what I'm using here is the pink satin fabric and then some white chiffon. And I'm using these as reference here for my circles. And we have, what is this, like 4 3/4 for the first size, 4 inches for the second size, about 3 1/4 for the third size, and 2 3/4 for the fourth size. We're gonna need some felt to felt the back, and you're gonna wanna put like a gem or something in the middle. And I have all kinds of stuff over here, pearls. You could put like a gem. These are like brads that I take the backs off of. And then I have some of these. I have all kinds of stuff. Okay, so just to get started, we're gonna start cutting out 2 of each circle. So what I'm gonna do is just kind of fold this in half, and your cutting doesn't need to be exact. Okay, so we have this I'm starting with, and I'm just gonna cut a circle around it, and I folded it over once, and then I'm just gonna lift it up and do the best I can to cut a better circle. It's just gonna cut around real quick. Do do do. And this last part. So this is what it ends up looking like, and it's a little funny right here, but like I said, it doesn't need to be perfect. And the reason I'm saying that is because you're going to light the ends with a lighter. Okay, so what I want you to do, I'm going to stop the video so you don't have to watch me do this entire thing, is cut 2 of each in every single circle that you have. You can make a template if you need to with the measurements that I provided, or you can make your new measurements, whatever you want to do. So we'll go ahead with that, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, I'm back. And so we got 2 in each size. Done. Now what we want to do is we're going to actually cut this into 5 spots, 5 cuts, okay? And I am randomly doing this, and it doesn't need to be perfect, so don't worry about it. And you see how far I'm cutting in? So 1 2 3 4, and the last one is 5. So this is the pink satin, and what we're gonna do is you're gonna flip this up, and if you don't like using a lighter, you can use a grill lighter because those would probably work better, and or you can use a candle, but then you might get some black stuff on your fabric here. So all we're gonna do is flip this up, and we're gonna light this, and you can light this as much as you want, but just be careful because you don't want to light it too much where it starts on fire. So you see this kind of curl I'm getting here, and you can go all the way down just like that. I'm just gonna do one more. And I wanted to mention, because I didn't mention before, if you just want to, you don't have to use you don't have to use chiffon if you don't want to, and you could just do multiple colors of satin, and it actually comes out very pretty. You could do like three of different satin colors if you wanted to for each layer or each size. So there we go. So this is what I started doing. Like I said, if you want to burn it a little bit more, you can go ahead. But then I'm gonna move on to this right here. And this is one that you do need to be careful with. And the only reason I'm saying that is because this flames up a lot faster. And it's a little bit more flimsy than the satin does, but here we go. Hopefully you see what I'm talking about when you start doing this yourself. You see that? And it's just curling up, just like this. Just do one more. Like I said, it's a little bit more flimsy, so it's hard to keep it. See, there we go. It lit on fire. I'm just gonna cut that little part off. And then I'll light it one more time. Oh no. Dang it, I got it over there, but it's not that big of a deal. Okay, so then you see what I'm talking about when we start to layer it? It's gonna look really, really pretty. So go ahead and finish all your cuts for every size that we have here, and then I'll be back in a second. All right, so we have them all done. It does take a while, as you probably noticed, to do every single layer. So all we're gonna do now is take your glue gun, push these out of the way, and yeah, do that. Obviously my glue gun's not working. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna set it on here. And then you're just gonna make a small little dot, and then you're gonna rotate the petals so they're not going the same way. And then be careful with the chiffon, because once you push down, you're actually gonna touch the hot glue. So if you wanna use something else to push it down, fine. I'm not suggesting anything to use with that, but there's the start, and it's starting to build up. Into something really pretty. So if you're using different colors, you can just rotate instead of doing two on top of one another. I get a piece of hair in there. If you want to see like this little end right here, you can go ahead and like trim that off and light it again if you want to. And you don't have to add much glue. I'm pushing down hard because my glue gun is being funny right now. And as you're doing this, watch for your circles. Actually, I'm gonna double layer this and then just put it on at the same time. You don't want it to start pushing like one way or the other as you're layering this. So you want the petals to be even. And then the last on the very top. And we have a nice, very full fabric flower. If you want to, you can go in here between the layers and glue it some more. It's up to you what you want to do. And then for the very top, I'm just going to spread this open a little bit like this. You can add whatever you want, like this. That might be a little bit too small to go in there. This, we have some gems here we can add in there, or some beads. We could do, as you see other people do it, you could just add like three little pearl beads. And I got these on a string. And I can't remember where I got these, but I think these are glass. I'm not quite sure. They're a little bit heavier, so I'm assuming they're glass. And then you could just add those right there in the middle, which I'm not gonna do right this time. And then on the back, if you wanna leave it like this, you're gonna just put a clip, cut out a circle, in which I'm gonna use, that seems kind of big, but we can cut it down more. This as a reference, and my pearl is running away from me. Like this. You see that? But you don't need to do it that way. Let me go get a hair clip real quick. Okay, so what you're going to want to do is line your hair clip, which I didn't do yet. You can make this circle a little cut a little bit better, but you're just basically going like this, glue it all down, glue it just like that, and there you go. Hair clip, hair bow done. But I'm not going to do that because we're going to keep going. I'm going to end this tutorial for this specific fabric flower, and then we're gonna start with doing rolled flowers, which are really easy, and then we're gonna assemble everything together after. I'm not sure if we're gonna stop at this second video. We'll see what happens, and then maybe put some feathers behind, add a little bit of decoration maybe. And then we'll put it onto a headband. So thanks for watching. Please leave a like and subscribe. Bye.